What I'd like to talk about is an experience I had when I was first diagnosed. I had a lot of problems in college with depression. I tried to commit suicide once. I quit college all at once, all abruptly, because I just couldn't take it anymore. And the same thing happened years later after I'd been working a job, and I just quit all of a sudden because I couldn't take it anymore. I had a lot of downtime, so I spent most of that time reading Slashdot, computer blogs, and sciencey stuff. I encountered this thing called the technological singularity, which is Ray Kurzweil's thing. It's a point in history where technology outpaces human abilities. I saw a lot of possibly devastating technologies on the rise. Bill Joy, the header of Sun Microsystems, that puts out Java, wrote this article in Wired referencing the Unabomber. No one's probably ever read the Unabomber Manifesto that I know of, but I've read it, and it's about technology and the destructive potential of advanced technology, and the asking of the peoples of the world to actually think about what technologies they allow to be introduced into the world, rather than to simply blindly manufacture whatever is possible. After leaving work, I got involved with a war protest. I drove my car 5 hours back to where we had been living, and it was kind of a wonderful experience to see like-minded individuals gathering together. Afterwards, they had a parade of naked women, which was also nice to see. But I had started at this point to bounce from being depressed to being something that I really hadn't been before, excessively happy. And determined, and finding strange things to be interesting. I found lichens to be really interesting. They're an example of symbiosis between an algae and a fungus. They're so tenacious on rocks, and they're beautiful to look at. So at this point, I didn't know what to do. I was starting to feel really good. I was doing a lot on the internet. I was emotionally disturbed by the possibility of a war. This is during the period leading up to the Iraq War. And I decided that I needed a change of scenery. So I went home to New Hampshire from California. And I only got worse. And I started seeing strange things on the internet. I didn't know what to make of it. But I saw references to myself in places that I wasn't being referenced, you know, on TV. And it's just a feeling, you know, it's like that. It's ethereal. It's something you can't latch on to, but it's something that you believe nonetheless. My parents didn't know what to do with me. The announcement came on the news that the bombs had been starting to drop. Well, before this, I'd sent a telegram to the president. I was convinced that it was my duty to inform people about the singularity. And the devastation that it will lead if we have a world of wars, an unstable world with advanced technologies. They're not going to mix. You can't have instability in the world and a device that is smaller than a grain of dust with the power to kill all human life. So, first day of the Iraq War comes, and I decided I needed to do something fantastic. And this idea came all at once. Actually, I felt like I had been hit in the head. I saw black for a fraction of a second, and I could hear a lump. Probably something snapped, and I snapped. I guess I wanted to be a martyr or something. I didn't care if I lived or died after that day. Had some model airplanes. I saw on the news on a website a picture that they actually discovered that the Iraqis were working on a drone airplane. So I decided to pack up my model airplanes into my parents' station wagon and along with some gasoline and a little trinkets that I had, any little thing that felt significant, I brought along with me. This was in the morning, so my parents weren't up yet, but as I was just about ready to leave, my parents woke up and were pushing my dad out of the way, because I was ready to leave. I was ready to leave, all right. So I went out. I was going to fly my airplanes at the school because they had a nice runway. But they had traffic, so I decided to go the other way towards the highway. I made my way to the highway, and on my way there, I picked up a police tail. I kept going. I didn't care at that point. I made it my way on the highway and had, I don't know how many police cars chasing me. I was throwing my airplanes out the window and flyers that I made. It's just being foolish. It was a low speed chase. I never went above 55. So it wasn't until later on in the highway when the blockade at the border stopped traffic that I encountered any other cars. The police put spike strips down, they popped some of my tires, and the roadblock stopped me. I crossed into Massachusetts. That was a mistake. But I ended up in, they asked me questions initially, and I said, I'm a prophet! And that's what they printed in the paper. Prophet chased, captured. Here I made CNN. Domestic terrorists. The Route 3 bomber. And they brought me to the Cambridge jail, where I saw a psychiatrist. And they sent me to Bridgewater State Hospital, where they medicated me. I spent 6 weeks there and I got out. And it's just a matter of clearing up the legal troubles. It was just a quick matter of insanity. Plea insanity, and I got off. Getting knocked on the head like that, or feeling as though I was knocked on the head, I mean, something physical probably happened. But that was my introduction to the mental health industry. War protester, prophet, terrorist.